Crossing stuff, you know, because I just really like Animal Crossing.
I want to see Metroid Prime 4, actually. I changed my mind. I want to see Metroid Prime 4.
It's been over 10 years since we've seen anything Metroid related, I think.
I mean, not Metroid Prime related. We saw the Samus Returns DS game from last year.
Oh yeah, it did. I forgot about the game, but I heard it was pretty good for whatever it was considered.
It was a solid game. It's worth your time.
I think, from what I heard, it was a remake of the Game Boy.
From Samus 2. Metroid 2, actually. We got Lucas and Diddy Kong. Oh, I remember Sidereus. He's the best Lucas player from Ontario area.
A nice hype for this boy, some fun.
And just juggled. Fast followers in the middle.
If anything, that's unfortunate for Fox entities that they can fall pretty fast.
Yeah.
Sometimes it can be a blessing, sometimes it can be a curse. But I can see what you mean by one of the best Lucas's, or maybe the best, I don't remember what you said there. But definitely, this Lucas being able to just hit these two anywhere.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure both HP and Sidereus are top 5 on the PR in the Ontario area, so. They're definitely no joke, and that Baxter's gonna take Fox Talk so early. But he's already off to a good lead here. Throwing Jet stuff out to Fox Talk Smash. And the reverse to the forward smash gonna take out the Noto Stock. Wow.
This team is one powerhouse right now. The reps from Canada are certainly showing that they got a lot going for them.
Almost hitting it again. He's gonna humble them, but he doesn't hit.
That throw is such a strong move on Lucas. I haven't really seen many Lucas, so I'm not really too aware of what's strong with him, but wow.
Even though it was stale, Fox is really light. I mean, we use the bridge. And the revenge of smash for IK says.
Well, this game already looking for blue team's favor because they've already got a lead.
Got a whole stock lead. Fox is almost dying that stage spike. Red team does have the energy advantage right now. Both swimmers are coming off stage and had Lucas. So Sidereus messed up the recovery.
Unfortunate for Lucas. But still, Nerd is still in a really good position right now, so as detrimental as it is,
and Red team's in the lead now.
Yeah, that's a little bit of a problem right there.
But Red team is a higher defense. If they take Park off the Noto, they will be able to be back in the game, and that's gonna do it. Oh no, he needs a pumble. If he pumbles, he would have died, I think.
Diddy Kong at least has a little more lunch to give it to the box.
Yeah, but if you just jump out of that down tilt in front, you won't be grabbed. And not a lot of people know about it.
Diddy's just trying to take out each other because they both know what kind of throw they can do to each other.
And
that down smash nearly being able to steal stock, but just not enough.
And you're gonna take a stock. Now the Nordos play really, 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 really careful.
I don't know if the share stock was the best bet.
I mean, you don't want to play the 1v2 ever, so you always want to help. And that's gonna do it. So now, case of half hit point. The Nordos cannot be the front man here.
But certainly, this Lucas could bring it back.
Fox cannot get camped here.
It's always nice to see when a Lucas or an S can recover from so far in, because it's always so hard to play when you don't know how to play other characters. But this Lucas really trying his best to play it as safe as possible. The banana might be enough to get.
Oh, the sweet spot. Oh,
wow.
Oh, wow. This is the most anticlimactic way to end it.
That was a smart Diddy Kong play, though. I just realized, ever since that share stuck, that Diddy Kong never took any damage.
I just realized that K-Sif died 5 times, and the Nord only died once.
Did K-Sif get all the kills?
Yeah.
Dang. Don't joke.
He was taking points the whole time. If you watch National Level, you'll see the Nord team with like Isaac Mars, and he was not getting hit. So making the Nord Zenoro is probably one of the best players in the world, to be honest. At doubles, he's really good at it.
I mean, he is on PR.
He's like. Taking an SD. Fox won't have a platform to extend his combos.
Starting with a PK freeze. PK freeze always looks like you can punish it, but this is a little too fast.
Now, blue team was also a really strong start last game, but then red team was able to adapt and come back. So let's see if blue team can try to replicate this success they had early on in the last game and try to hold on to it. And,
that nair could have been something special there.
Oh my god, things are happening.
Things are happening.
That happened. HP dive. Charge with the PK freeze. And now we got HP offstage. And the throw's going a little too deep. And HP's going to kick back anyway.
That was just a little too deep. That looks really weird. Looks like Zenono's Diddy Kong certainly knows how to deal with the enemies right now. The Fox being able to bring back, and I thought he was dead on.
Back throw? Nope.
I think it's a body shift for that PK fight.
I was smashed a little stale, so I'm not gonna kill yet. Back throw, back throw, just take it though.
Unfortunately, up smash not being able to do much. It sucks because that move is amazingly powerful. Back and forth because it seems this is a lot more
difficult. Zenoro is so good at facing his fair forward air so don't only hit the enemy and not the teammate.
Just planning one clear down tilt but not being able to get any conversions off of that was a little weird personally, but you know.
Lucas, so much damage there.
Zenoro's just trying to find so many ways to approach, but unfortunately none of them seem to be connecting very well. And it's Lucas just kind of handling the Zenoro right now and just not letting it do anything.
And not gonna do it.
A very strong move coming up from the Lucas right now.
Back throw,
being able to seal a stock like that. This Lucas is amazing at being able to apply pressure like that. And that banana not being able to do much, but on the stage anyways, being a little bit of a threat. This Diddy Kong is in high range to be killed though, so any hit will probably be able to take away the stock.
That was smart recovery there by HP.
And the forward smash being able to take out the other Diddy Kong. And now this game is looking a lot more in Zenoro and KSM's favor right now.
Yep.
That back throw almost being able to kill their own team. That was a little unfortunate, but the up tilt being able to get killed the Diddy Kong finally. It's a little bit of a dangerous situation for both the Lucas and the Fox because they're at a pretty high percentage considered. With the Lucas gone, there might still be a shot for the Diddy Kong because it's Diddy Kong. Diddy Kong is a really good, solid character. A lot of safe options, especially with the down tilt. But it's looking like this is certainly going to be a red dead game right now.
Yeah. Then around KFAP to get 2-0, and they're on their winner's final. I think I'm going to be done commentating. My voice is a little sore.